Look at that beautiful hadith in Bukhari Sharif. When there is contentment in the heart, food for thought in particular for our sisters. Atta ibn Abi Rubah says, Abdullah ibn Abbas radiallahu anhu tells me, Ala urika imra'atan min ahlil jannah. Should I not show you a woman of Jannah? I said, please do tell me. He said, Hadhihi al-mar'atu sawda. Atatin nabiyya sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. You see this woman of Abyssinian origin? Come, I tell you a story about this woman. She one day came to Nabi alayhi salam. Look at the condition in her life. Ya Rasulallah, inni usra'u wa atakashaf. O Nabi of Allah, I suffer from epilepsy. Now what a fatal illness she is suffering. What is sickness? O Nabi of Allah, I suffer from epilepsy. And when I have these attacks, my satr is exposed. Could you perhaps make dua to Allah that Allah cures me? Now what a tragedy in a life. It warrants total depression. Subhanallah, what are the teachings of Nabi Kareem sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? The Nabi of Allah, one was to lift his hands and instantly make dua and Allah will respond positively and cure the woman. But the Nabi of Allah gave her a choice. In shi'ti da'awtu Allah an yu'afik. Wa in shi'ti sabarti walakil jannah. You have one of two choices. If you so wish, I will make dua to Allah now. He will cure you instantly, permanently, totally. On the other hand, if you endure, persevere, and exercise patience, I promise you, Jannat is yours. Now, in today's terms, when a person understands that sickness means depression, it means medical expenses, it means burdening the family, it entails a host of other things. Naturally, a person is so desperate for cure, he'll do anything and everything. The Nabi of Allah asked this woman, if you want, I make dua to Allah, Allah will cure you. And if you want, you make sabr and jannah. Now she is suffering epilepsy. Subhanallah, contentment. She says, O Nabi of Allah, if you promise that I have patience, jannah is mine, then I will prefer living with this sickness. And I will prefer dying with this sickness. As long as you can confirm jannah is mine. However, I am very conscious of my modesty. And when I have my epilepsy attacks, my sitr is unveiled and it is exposed. I want you to make that amount of dua that in the future attacks that I have, my sitr mustn't be unveiled. There was a time when a woman was conscious of her morality in the midst of sickness, which perhaps anyone can debate as she been excused in the sense of the sickness that she has. The Nabi of Allah made dua that in the future attacks that she has, her sitr mustn't be exposed. But Allah gave her contentment on her sickness. She lived with epilepsy, she died with epilepsy, and on the tongue of Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, her abode in Jannat was confirmed. Hence it is a perception, it is a deception, it is a delusion that if I am healthy and I am wealthy, I am successful and I am content. هي القناعة فالزمها تعش ملكا لو لم يكن منها إلا راحة البدن. It is contentment. Grab onto it. I swear by Allah, if you have it, you're a king without a throne also.